Hi, this is Martin Boyer with Austin Boats and Motors. We just received a 2013 Blue Wave 2400 Pure Bay. And I'm going to walk you through the boat, do a video walk around presentation for you, get pretty detailed and go through some of the really high points on the boat and some of the detail work that's also been done. It's a very custom boat. The 2400 Pure Bay is Blue Wave's largest center console bay boat style boat. It's got a huge front deck. Large casting deck in the stern part of the boat. This one's got a lot of upgrades in it. So I'll start from the outside and we'll work our way in. First thing I want to point out is trailer. We don't talk a lot about trailers typically because it kind of means to an end. You've got to have one obviously to get to the water, but we're going to talk about this one for just a minute because we've done a lot of things to it. You'll notice there's a brake package on it. Hydraulic brakes, surge brakes. It is a cross-drilled disc brake, so it's a great saltwater brake system if you're going to put the boat in salt water. It's got the Stoltz bow roller, non-marring upgrade. Helps keep the boat's gel coat looking like it's supposed to. And you'll see that the channel and the main beams on this are all Line-X'd. It's basically a powder coating material. It has a kind of elasticity to something similar to like a Rhino liner like you're used to seeing in the back of a truck. But it's designed to coat aluminum as opposed to steel. So it's got a really good baked on feel to it. Easy to clean. Won't water spot quite as bad or tarnish quite as bad as raw aluminum will. So gives the boat a really custom look, especially with a black boat set up like we've got here. You can see it just gives it an amazing look. No one's doing that in the marketplace. We've been working with McLean to help us get this finished look. They do a great job. They're out of Houston. Highly recommend them, and it's all we use under our Blue Waves. This one comes with the Vault lubrication system. So at the Vault lubrication system, you're going to have a 10-year unlimited mileage warranty that comes with the product as far as the hubs are concerned. So here's your Vault hub system. It's no maintenance, no leaks, and 10 years trouble-free ownership. Upgraded a black chrome wheel set. These are custom. We have those made for us to go on this trailer when we do this powder coated Line-X upgrade. Big nice steps in the back to get in the boat. Most of your trailers will have a fender about half that size. Fender step in the back of the fender. Same thing in the front. Really good sized. Normally you have about that much step. Got about twice the step space to get up into the boat. When we do that, we also upgrade to LED lights. They're more durable. They last a lot longer and they won't fail when you back them in and out of the water. Real nice four bunk trailer setup. You can see here we've got our high speed pickups for our aeration system in the boat. We'll go through that in a minute. Got your 3.5-inch ID drain for your Pro Series live wells, which I'll go over as well. There's your overboard scuppers from the floor drains. You notice we have Lenco hydraulic tabs. Lenco Marine is by far the best in the industry when it comes to tabs and hydraulic tabs, electric tabs. I was going to say this till we got inside the boat, but I got to start talking about it now, I guess. We're looking at a ladder here. This ladder is standard on a Pure Bay, but the powder coating is not. And I'm going to take you through the boat inside, and you'll see there's powder coating everywhere we can powder coat. This has a powder coat upgrade package on it. Really nice finish. This is a real deep ladder with tall handles on it. So I'm just going to step back to give you the effect here. If you're in the water, very functional ladder. It's not just a ladder for saying I have a ladder's sake. It's a ladder you can really get in and get on and climb up with. Come in real handy. Atlas jack plate. Got you a nice 10-inch setback there. Hydraulic, maintenance free. 300 horse long shaft Yamaha XCA motor. XCA is their digital command shift motor, and so this one's got command link in it. We've upgraded to command link. Also upgraded command link, which is digital shift and digital throttle, to command link plus, which gives us a diagnostic gauge package in the dash, an LCD screen if you will. I'll talk about that in a minute in detail as well, go through what that gives you. Tons of storage. You can see the back deck. I've got it all flatted out so you can see kind of what it would look like if it was in a fishing mode. Upgraded hydraulic shocks. Not standard on this boat. We upgrade and put a hydraulic shocks package on it. So we get three lids in the front, with hydraulic shocks and two lids in the back with hydraulic shocks. One thing we started doing a couple years ago is putting a stainless steel Perco recessed rear facing rod holder. That came to us by way of a service manager, a certain style of fishing that he does. He likes to fish holes deep in the coastal, intercoastal area, and found that to be real helpful. We've started putting it on some of our larger boats. We found that a lot of consumers really like that feature. Number one, it gives you more rod holder space. Number two, if you're anchored up somewhere shallow and you're fishing back into some deeper water holes, this gives you a real good way to not have to have your hands on the rod the entire time when you're fishing like that. See the recess cleat, 5-inch recess cleat. It's pull up, push down, won't snag yourself. Got a water pressurized water system here. You can hook a water hose, which comes with the boat, to this. It's raw water. You just spin this off, connect your hose to it, and then you can control how much pressure from the valve head. The valve head here, located right on the end of it, will actually give you complete control over what kind of pressure that you actually use. And it comes in real handy for washing the deck down. You got fish guts, you know, all over the floor, or sand from the kids jumping in and out of the boat, that kind of thing. You can just hook a hose to that, use this valve right here to control the pressure, and then it gives you a really good way to kind of get the dirtier part of the boat cleaned up until you can get home and really finish polishing it off. There's a switch that activates the pump in the dash, and then you connect your hose to this. You'll see LED lights throughout the boat. These are standard features on the Blue Waves. We have LED lights in the console, LED lights back here in the back deck wall. We even have LED lights in the live well. So we got LEDs pretty much everywhere. We got LEDs shining down underneath the side gunnel mounted rod holders over here, so you can see your rods at night. Really nice effect. This is your overflow drain for your live well. That's the LED light. That's your recirculation screen. And then over here, that's basically an aquarium stone. It's hooked to what would be a bubbler in most aquarium environments. It's called Pro Air when you install in a boat. We can plumb two live wells with one Pro Air pump. So this boat has a two live well system in it. Both of them are plumbed with Pro Air. Basically brings oxygen into the live well without having to turn the water over and recirculate the water that's in the live well to get oxygen content increased. So that comes in real handy when you're trying to catch bass and keep them alive, or especially when you're trying to keep finicky bait alive longer, mainly shrimp and croaker and even piggy perch when it's really hot, can use a little more oxygen, so that's helpful. You'll notice that we do all gray interior when we do a gray-black boat like this. This gray-black is something that we've popularized in the last year or so. We sell a lot of that style. You'll see the interior is all gray. The reason we do that is, one, it helps hide the dirt, and number two, it helps keep the glare down. One thing people don't think about when they buy white shiny boats is glare, and it's a problem, especially on the coast. Even with mirrored glasses, you get a lot of glare off the deck from the sun shining down on it, bouncing back at your eyes. So the gray dull finish gives it a really anti-reflective finish and surface, so it really helps cut down on that. Like I said, also hides the dirt. When we do that, we go to gray upholstery. You see the really nice, comfortable high back seats in the back. These jump seats are recessed. They're a little lower. They're not flush with the deck. So your legs, when you're sitting there, have a nice bent knee position, good lumbar support, got armrests on both sides. Just a very nice finished product jump seat. Fold these armrests up, flip this seat down. It latches here, and then you're back to a fishing platform in the back. Also, you'll notice these rod holders here, they are rod holders, so you end up with four across the back deck in total. But what these two in the center are for is actually for a slide-in backrest that goes across here. And you'll notice the little snap heads across the back here and across the front. And that's actually for a snap pad that's standard with the 2400 Pure Bay that snaps across the live well lid, makes a cushioned seat bottom, and then that backrest is padded and upholstered as well. It slides into these two rod holders, and now you have one continuous seat all the way across the back. Think of it as a bench seat, if you will. And so you have two jump seats on the outside edge and a seat for two in the middle when you put that in. So you can have four cross seating in this boat. Plus, we have the upgraded 100 quart cyclone system, which is swivel and slide mechanism. So this will slide in and out. It'll also swivel around 360 degrees. Folds down, so when you're going down a highway, you can keep it from the wind grabbing it. So you can sit here, fish off the back. You turn it off to the side, fish off to the side, And then when the weather's getting a little inclement, you can slide them in towards each other and get behind the console. This is just, man, I tell you, one of my favorite features on the boat. I really think the Cyclone seat is the way to go. The versatility to be able to spin it around, face out the side and fish, get behind the console when it's cold or raining. Just the versatility of it, just amazing. And the one thing I really like about it is you have the ability to have some lumbar support and you're making those long runs. You've got that backrest instead of just a flat leaning post. You've got a backrest that really gives you some great support. So when you're going down the lake or cruising intercoastal or heading across Baffin Bay and it gets rough, you've got what you need there to make it comfortable. So I talked about a couple upgrades when we were outside the boat. One of the ones I need to make sure and mention, I'll mention it now so I don't forget, is the console. This is their TE Tournament Tall Series console. It's the same footprint at the bottom, so you get all that great walk-around space around the console. It doesn't take up any more room, but it curves in and goes up about 14 inches taller, and then we can flush mount electronics in there. We can put a 12-inch Lowrance touchscreen right here, center-mounted. We've got our power knob steering wheel. Everything's right here, easy to access. I can reach over here very easy to grab these switches. I've got resettable breakers for every switch across here, my Lenco trim tab control, my jack plate trim lever control that we've upgraded the boat with, command link, shift and throttle, so easy. Man, I just, every time I grab this thing and put it into gear, it's just amazing the difference between cables and electronic shift, just night and day. Underneath here, this is where we'll install your batteries and battery charger. If you upgrade with a trolling motor to the boat, we'll install 3 batteries in here, and then we'll have that battery charger in there. And any other electronics equipment, if you want to do, say, a Lowrance Sonic Hub, like an audio media server, we can put speakers and link all that to your Lowrance and network it, and then you can control your iPhone, iPod, and music and so forth through your Lowrance electronics. We'd mount that kind of stuff under the dash back there. Seat base is mounted, so if you want a seat, the hard work's done. Just order the seat of your choice. Usually gray and black looks best with this boat. Got a nice anchor locker in the front. Pre-wired for trolling motor from the factory. And a trim switch here so we can control the motor height in the back as we're fishing. Nice tie-off cleat, got a built-in landing. It's engineered, structurally supportive for a trolling motor. That's what it's designed for there. You'll see here on the front deck, we got an integrated step and then an in-floor storage. So there's a couple things going on here. We've got a cast net storage here, or any kind of storage. You know, life vest, ropes and bumpers, but typically cast nets and rubber boots go in there and waders. Then we've got some storage in here. This is the cushion that I was telling you about that actually goes across the back. This is drained outside of to build for a pump over, and you can't ice that. So you can turn that into a Ford ice chest or a small fish box. Rod locker. 5 rod tubes. Let me tell you, you can double those up. So if you're crunched for space, got a lot of guys, you can put 10 in here. Also doubles as a 50 quart fish box. See the drain? And it's insulated. So great place to put fish. Same thing here, rod holder or your choice, fish box, 50 quart. Again, 5 tubes, you can double those up, put 10 rods. Here's another example of the stainless steel shock upgrade that we have added at the factory. Another shock, your nav light keeper. That's your hinged backrest for the back deck that I spent some time talking about. It makes that backrest for you, so you've got that bench style seating across the back. Again, it's insulated with a drain. You can put tackle in it, or wetsuits, or man, you can turn that into a big ice box if you needed to, if you're having one of those amazing days on the water. It's a 9-person rated boat. Stainless steel cup holders throughout. You can see, haven't talked about it, I'm going to talk about it now, what an amazing job they do on their T-tops. This is a black T-top, all powder coated, of course, to match the boat. It's a 5x7, got good shade. Just a really good look. Something I'm real excited about is one of the very first boats in the marketplace with this new feature. They previewed it July at the owner's tournament down at Corpus. And it was a prototype at that time. Now it's all finished and ready to go. This is console for, front storage. Got nice vertical storage here. 2 drawers to organize your tackle. You know, handheld GPS, radios, cell phones, maps, bags of gulps. 2 glove boxes, black frame, 1 on each side of the boat, 3 recessed rod holders. Come around the other side, there's our other rod holders.
And our other glove box.
So with this slit out, you can see now we have access, full access to it. It's very easy to get to and open. We can reach in fully, get what we need, and close it. We had access issues before because of the height and the clearance here. So with this new slide system with the handle on it, we fixed that problem. And so now we have the ability to lock this to where it's locked open, or we can push it back in and lock it into that position and get it out of the way. Either way, though, we have that versatility now, that flexibility, and it's on a nice slide, so we're not sitting there having to manhandle this ice chest when it's full of ice and your favorite beverage. Let me step back out of the boat and give you another look at it here. So much to talk about on this boat. Apologize for the long video. Hopefully it was helpful. There's so much detail to this boat, and the customization that's been done on it is very high level. So I want to try and capture that as well as I could. You'll see the Pro Series graphics. Crystal caps raised, blue wave logo, very nice feature. Black with a great bottom. Tons of front deck space. Let me get up here, let you see a little better what I'm talking about. And you've got the kind of casting space you'd see in a 20 or 21 foot bass boat. You know, they're known for having that front deck space, and you're capturing all that here on this 2400 Pure Bay. Console stripe, forgot to talk about that. Got a console stripe, it's an upgrade option to match the boat, the outside of the boat. You'll see the two LED lights in the front. Not sure what else to go over with you. Blackout kit. One thing I forgot, blackout kit. So we blackout, I mean, it's little things. It's just so detail oriented. I want to try and point it out. Got blacked out hinges instead of white, which would be standard. Blacked out side panels on the Cyclone. Blacked out console doors. Blacked out glove boxes. Blacked out side gunnel rod holders. Blacked out raw water washdown connect over there. We talked about that earlier. Black bungee tie down for the jump seat. Attention to detail. That's something you're gonna find a lot with Blue Wave. We help them customize stuff like this, and boy, what a winning package. If that boat doesn't jump out at you, then something's wrong with you. That's about a 62, 63 mile an hour boat, loaded up. It's nice, it's a legit boat. Rough water handling is the best. I've been in Cocodrie outside the Barrier Islands in Louisiana in a boat like this, and I know how it handles in rough water. It handles great in our intercoastal system down on the Texas Gulf Coast. If you like to run intercoastal system and you like to get somewhere fast, this boat will do that too. So there's really nothing this boat won't do. Call us for more information and to get some answers to your questions. I'm sure you've got a few. Number's 512-263-2811. You can follow us on Facebook, Austin Boats on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Our website's austinboats.com. Again, my name's Martin. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Look forward to catching up with you. Give us a call anytime.